The Trump administration recently came out with a budget plan calling for dramatic cuts in domestic spending. The cuts would offset higher spending on the military and immigration enforcement. Among the changes that would affect the neighborhoods here is the elimination of the Community Development Block Grants, the CDBG program. Much of that spending in Boston goes to the Department of Neighborhood Development with programs for housing and business districts. To tell us about the programs is our guest from the department, the Director of Operations, Devin Quirk. Thank you very much for being with us, Devin.
Glad to be here, Chris. Thank you.
Devin, I want to have you go back to the press conference that the mayor recently put together about this, and that included people talking about how this money is used. And one of the people I remember was a woman who got some help from the home center fixing up her three-decker. Why was that so important?
I think what's really important right off the bat when people are thinking about these cuts is they're not cuts to big bureaucracies or faceless government programs. These are cuts to people and real services, real people services that people really need in Boston. The city of Boston gets about $22 million a year in CDBG funds, $4 million a year in HUD home funds. And these are funds that we use to help make our neighborhoods better and to really help people. So we touch about 13,000 individuals every year with this funding. We touch another 3,500 businesses and in the Main Street districts. We build about 300 units of affordable housing each year. So if we're going to cut these funds, it makes a dramatic impact in real people's lives. And I think that's one of the things that Mayor Walsh has been trying to highlight, is that this is about people, not just money.
Well, 40 years ago, I remember CDBG money being used to fix up three-deckers in neighborhoods that were just swamped with disinvestment. Yeah. Now they're swamped with, I guess, gentrification. Yeah. Do you still need this money?
Yeah, absolutely. We absolutely still need this money. I think the federal government is one source of funds where we can really prevent displacement and gentrification in our neighborhood. So that's something the mayor's been highlighting. We want to go back to the mayor's press conference. I mean, he brought in people from across Boston's neighborhoods to talk about how we're really using these funds. He had a person from East Boston Main Streets talking about the 20 Main Street districts that are in Boston and how Bostonians are using funds from CDBG and other programs to help small businesses, particularly minority and women-owned businesses, grow and thrive. We're helping senior homeowners stay in their homes. We met a woman at that press conference who got money to buy her first home, a triple-decker in Mattapan, and she wouldn't have been able to do that without CDBG. So we absolutely need this funding. We absolutely need it to help our neighborhoods remain strong.
And I guess to qualify that money, you've got to be an owner-occupant. So this could be maybe the difference between an owner-occupant or an absentee investor.
Yeah, absolutely. I think homeownership is about wealth creation in our neighborhoods, having funding tools that actually help people purchase their first home. We also run classes in the Boston Home Center, so it's not just down payment assistance. It's also teaching you about what homeownership means to you, whether or not it's the right choice for you. These are all programs we fund with community development block grants, and we don't have another source for those funds. So the mayor's pushed back hard. He's called this proposed budget cut by President Trump irresponsible, reckless, and he's also called it heartless, and I think that's the right word for it.
This is BNN News. We're talking with Devin Quirk from the Department of Neighborhood and Development. I want to come back to the money for the business districts because at one time these districts were struggling. They had to really reinvent themselves, and now we'll talk about Maverick Square, for instance, how this money has helped Maverick Square.
Yeah, so I think all across Boston's Main Street districts, there's 20 of them. Each one's a little bit different. You know, they're the main street of that community. It's the little commercial downtown of our neighborhoods. Some neighborhood business districts, the only funding that they get is through community development block grants. Other districts that are thriving maybe are able to fundraise independently a little bit more and get some more funding. But what they use that funding for is promoting the Main Street District, helping the small businesses that are in that neighborhood with technical assistance, whether that's sort of on the back end, financial assistance, or on the front end, marketing. They also help with financial loans and grants, micro grants to small businesses to help them get started and to really thrive.
And I think a lot of this, it's not the chains as much as the small businesses, the mom and pop business, that place in Maverick Square where I got the burrito.
Exactly. Kind of it's the people, right? I just want to keep bringing it back to that. That these funding programs aren't these amorphous, faceless things. They help real people in our neighborhoods, and they're small dollar value for each individual transaction to that homeowner or to that small business, but they add up to a lot. $26 million, in fact, across the city of Boston. That's a third of our entire budget of the Department of Neighborhood Development. So we can't have the impact that we have without this federal funding.
Having heard all of this, how do you bounce that off of what Trump's budget director, Mick Mulvaney, said? This is money we can't afford to spend because it's going to programs that don't show they work.
Yeah, well, I think there are thousands and thousands of people in Boston who can prove to you just how well these programs work for Bostonians. I also think that it's really important to realize that Massachusetts and the city of Boston are a donor state. We're giving more money to the federal government than we get back in our block grants. So I think it's only fair that we continue to get this money, and I think that's why Mayor Walsh continues to push back hard against President Trump. And we're also looking for other sources too. I don't want to give a doom and gloom message. Mayor Walsh has seen this trend. I mean, this isn't just this administration that stepped away from funding urban programs. So we're looking at local sources too. So there are other ways that we can think about funding programs going forward. But no city can replace the level of investment that the federal government can place in our urban centers.
Speaking broadly of community development, there are other federal programs that are relevant as well from the Department of Housing and Urban Development. The Choice Neighborhoods Program is a competitive grant program, but that so far has been pretty important for, I guess, salvaging and renewing some of the public housing in Boston.
Yeah. What I would call a parting gift from the Obama administration. We got a $30 million grant to totally renovate the Whittier Street housing development and the surrounding neighborhood. That's going to be a transformational project for Dudley Square. You can imagine what $30 million will do for just one housing development. It's going to be mixed use, completely renovated, new retail, community investments in the street life and parks, in cultural centers. That's a tremendously important catalyst. I think it's tragic that the federal government is stepping away from programs like Choice Neighborhoods. I guess the difference between Choice Neighborhoods and community development block grants is that we depend on community development block grants. We get them every year. Choice Neighborhoods is competitive. So we're the only city that's won two Choice Neighborhoods grants. We'd love to keep competing for more, but it doesn't change next year's budget. The elimination of CDBG would change next year's budget.
And what's going on in these Choice Neighborhood developments is that at least on paper, you're saying that people who live there in the public housing now will not be displaced. They can come back. Yeah. But you're also adding to the supply of housing, too.
Absolutely. Yeah. And that's fundamentally true. Everyone has a right to return as a renovation project proceeds. It's overwhelmingly supported by the residents of public housing. So that's fundamentally important that the primary beneficiary of the project needs to be the people living in public housing today. But we have a housing crisis. We need more housing in our city. And one of the things that this Choice Neighborhood grant in the Whittier Street instance is doing is just adding to the housing supply and the diversity housing, vertical diversity within the building. So it's not just low-income individuals living in that household in that building. It's also people at moderate income, middle income, and up, so that you have true economic diversity in public housing.
Thank you very much for being with us.
Glad to be here, Chris. Thank you very much.
Devin Quirk from the Department of Neighborhood Development. We'll have more news in just a moment.